السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 2055 and focus on the 10th of Zulhijjah. It was on the 10th of Zulhijjah that Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alaihi wasallam Sahaba used to read the Eid Salat, and this is Eid al-Adha. After Ramadan, first Shawwal, that is Eid al-Fitr, and here the 10th of Zulhijjah is Eid al-Adha, where you sacrifice the animal, the goat, the sheep, the cow, or the camel. And remember, Almighty Allah teaches us, فَصَلِّ لِرَبِّكَ وَانْحَرْ, that perform your Eid Salat. And remember that after you perform your Eid Salat, then what must you do? That you must go and slaughter and sacrifice. So that is the mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. And we must read Takbir. لِتُكَبِّرُ اللَّهَ عَلَى مَا هَدَاكُمْ. Almighty Allah Jalla Wala has given us priority number one. And therefore we read Takbir loudly when we go towards the Eidgah, the Masjid, the Musalla, wherever we are performing. And remember, give out charity. And when we slaughter, then the meat also, at least one third is desirable, meritorious, we give to the poor and the needy. So in that way there, we empower them as well. And remember, after the Eid Salat and the khutbah and so forth, then say, تَقَبَّلَ اللَّهُ مِنَّا وَمِنْكُمْ, that may Almighty Allah Jalla Wala accept whatever ibadat you did, whatever ibadat I did. And remember, for all our ibadat to be accepted in the court of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala, we must then reconcile with one another. So that is a big condition. Second one, remember, is this: on the 10th of Zulhijjah 1427, the 31st of December, the end of the year, 31st December 2006, the Iraqi leader and President Saddam Hussein was put to death, and he passed away as a martyr and shaheed. We're not saying he didn't commit major crimes and sins. He read the Kalima, he was executed on the morning of Eid al-Adha. All the Islam Muslim countries opposed this out of respect for Eid al-Adha, except the Kuffar, Shias in Iran, due to the lack of respect of Eid al-Adha. And remember that they are Kuffar, they were responsible for this. I've been to Iraq, I've been to Iran with the help and mercy of Almighty Allah Jalla Wala. Remember, as long as Saddam was alive, so the Shias could not say anything. Today, from the mimbers in Iraq, so they swear, cursing Sayyidina Abu Bakr, Sayyidina Umar, Sayyidina Usman, Sayyidina Aisha, Allah forbid, Allah forbid. So that is what they did. So we say, may Almighty Allah Jalla Wala forgive Saddam Hussein, grant him Jannatul Firdaus, that he passed away a Sunni, he passed away with Iman and Islam. Yes, mistakes, sins, all that of us we commit, and that is between him and Almighty Allah. So Almighty Allah has the day of justice. But any person passes away from the Ahlul Sunnah wal Jama'ah, then we will make dua for them. And as far as the Shia Kuffar go, we say la'anatullahi alayhim, Allah's curse is upon them. The hadith is mentioned in Tirmidhi Sharif, idha ra'aytumul ladina yasubbuna ashabi, when you see those people cursing, swearing my sahaba, then say faqulu la'anatullahi ala sharrikum, Allah's curse be upon you. So that's exactly what Mustafa sallallahu alaihi wasallam taught us, the hadith in Tirmidhi Sharif. So we wish all of you a wonderful Eid al-Adha, and whether you are celebrating on Tuesday or Wednesday, barakallahu feek. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Assalamu alaikum.